you take any polygon, make a copy, and stick the two together, you get a flat degenerate polyhedron with two faces, called a dihedron. If you start with a regular polygon, such as a square, you end up with a regular dihedron. You might remember the definition of a platonic solid from previous videos. This square dihedron has regular faces. Both faces are the same. Each vertex is the same, bordering two faces. And it's not concave, so it must be convex. So it meets all the conditions for being a platonic solid. The only reason it's not normally counted as a platonic solid is because it's flat, not three-dimensional, so it's not a true polyhedron. There's no official definition of a polyhedron, but most people agree that they should be three-dimensional. There are an infinite number of regular dihedra, from the triangular dihedron upwards. If we try to find the dual of a dihedron, such as this hexagonal dihedron, things get weirder. Remember, a dual is a swapping of faces and vertices. Each vertex of a dihedron borders two faces, so the dual of a dihedron has faces with two vertices. These are called digons. A digon looks the same as a line segment. Its two edges coincide, and it has zero surface area. The dual of this hexagonal dihedron is six digons. Shown correctly, the digons stretch to infinity and they all coincide, passing through the center of the dihedron. This is called a hosohedron. Again, this is an infinite family, from the triangular hosohedron upwards. Dihedra and hosohedra make more sense if we view them as spherical polyhedra. For example, given a cube, we can make a spherical cube by drawing a sphere around the cube and projecting the cube outwards onto the sphere. The edges become spherical arcs and the faces become curved. Any polyhedron can be viewed as a spherical polyhedron. For a dihedron, one face is pulled up to the north pole of the sphere and the other pulled down to the south pole. The vertices form a ring around the equator, connected by a great circle of edges. As for the hosohedron, the two vertices at infinity map to the north and south poles, and the digonal faces become so-called lunes, like segments of an orange. If we bring together a spherical dihedron and hosohedron, we can see that they are indeed dual. Each red dihedron vertex lies at the centre of a hosohedron face, and vice versa. Thank you for watching. Please give a like if you enjoyed the video, and see you next time.